afternoon, everybody. Thank you very much from Trusted Object. So the transition with the previous presentation, I saw that the last slide presented was talking about certification. Maybe one certification was missing, so it's maybe not a good news, the security certification. So I propose you that during this presentation to introduce the European Cyber Security Regulation and the associated European Certification Scheme that will be introduced quite soon. And my objective here is also to put in perspective this certification scheme with the LoRa security specification, of course. Only a few words about Trusted Object, for those who don't know Trusted Object. So Trusted Object... Yes, okay, thank you very much. So, the company has been founded in 2014, so 5 years ago, and we are a player in the field in the cyber security for IoT, providing solutions for the IoT chain and IoT device. With secure embedded software, secure library, or generic MCU, secure connectivity stack, and personalization and provisioning solution. Presence in Europe and in Asia. Sorry, that's why I have to direct. So what is the European Cybersecurity Act? So this is the cybersecurity regulation focusing on ICT product and ICT services. And of course, the IoT device are part of the scope. And under this regulation, different certification scheme are being introduced. Of course, one target also of the cybersecurity, European Cybersecurity Act is, I will go further into detail, is to propose the unification of the different national certification scheme. We'll see that in a specific slide. Something important, and I talked about that just previously, a new certification, the security one, yes, because this certification and what I will be talking about is really completely separate and independent of the LoRaWAN certification, of course. So to give you further information on this certification, so as a beginning, this certification will be a voluntary approach. Not all the products have the same request in terms of certification scheme. And something interesting in this scheme is that three different assurance levels will be proposed. I will go in the detail, of course, to give you further information on that. So what we call the basic, substantial, and high level. Something important in this certification scheme is that the security by design is a dominant approach defined more or less in everywhere. All the players in the ecosystem clearly are convinced that this certification at, I would say, medium term probably will become mandatory. I don't know if it is useful to highlight that, but certification, of course, will give trust. Trust is one of the barriers for a successful deployment of IoT and for LoRaWAN, so it's really something expected by many players, to be honest. So it's an additional certification, as I said at the beginning, but it's really expected due to this point, the trust. Something expected also, you will see that in maybe the next slide, the fact that the unification of a certification scheme will give also additional trust for the deployment of the IoT. This sentence are coming from the Cybersecurity Act. Yes, it's on. So to go further in the detail, yes. So as I said, not all the product will require the same certification, same security, and the same certification level. Security requirement and the associated evaluation criteria are not the same. You can imagine, if we are looking at the application, are not the same for consumer, for instance, for thermostat. The request will not be the same in enterprise. Enterprise, for instance, it can be a smart lighting services. In industrial, if I want to monitor the efficiency of critical machinery, or what we call critical here is typically energy, water, utilities, health, or government application. Why the security requirement is different? Because the risk is different, and the exposure to attacks are really different depending on the application in the market. And the certification scale, of course, taking into account all these parameters. The security objective. If I will detail a little bit more the three security assurance levels. So for the basic, as you can imagine, it's really for device with low risk. You will have security guideline, and it will be an important point. It will be a self assessment. If we look at the substantial security assurance level, so in this case, the goal is really to reduce substantially the risk of cybersecurity incident. And in this case, so your device, we have to run pen test, and the third party will be involved, what we call the CAB, called the Conformance Assessment Body. So for the evaluation and for the certification, it's two bodies, so a third party will be involved for the security assurance level. For the third assurance level, the I1, of course here we are targeting device really exposed to state-of-the-art cyber security. So the same, you will have a pen test, and you will have also third party involved for the evaluation and the certification. You have today you have different certification scheme, private or public initiative. I will give you an example. I will go into detail with the Eurosmart scheme, but have in mind that, and you have probably heard about already a certification scheme. What I would like to mention here is that not all these certification scheme will be compliant with the European Cybersecurity Act. And if you want to really, I started to compare the different scheme, but if you want to go into the details to compare the certification scheme, I know that on July a study will be published really to compare the different levels. You have, I would say, company initiative as ARM and XP, and you have, I would say, more association or public initiative. So today, the framework is, I would say, a little bit complex, national-wide. It's why an European scheme, quite really recognized and adopted, will be really useful. I selected Eurosmart. It's not only trusted object is part of the Eurosmart, but what is the advantage of Eurosmart certification scheme versus other certification scheme is the fact that Eurosmart is an association with 32 members, representative of the digital security, and you are coming from the member, are coming from the industry, laboratories, research. Richard's lab also, so it means it's compared to a company initiative, I would say it's representative of the security industry today in Europe. So it's why I will focus and I will give you some information on this security scheme to be a little bit more clear. In the Eurosmart security scheme, and I guess that you can find that in other certification scheme, A notion is very important is the TOE, so this is the target of evaluation. In OroSmart, the TOE is modular, and actually you can define the perimeter of the certification from a full hardware platform, including the connectivity, to the simple component. So what is the advantage? If you manage on your side, on your device, a certification, you can imagine that you have the benefit to use a subsystem or component already certified, because you will reduce the cost and you will speed the certification also. So what is the typical, so it's really a high level because there are many things to explain in the certification flow, but just to give you an example of the flow for OroSmart, you define the security profile, which is more or less a security requirement. So you have a questionnaire, and you have the evaluation and the certification with third party or self-assessment if necessary. Something really important for OroSmart compared to other schematics, the goal was really for the certification to talk about days in terms of duration. Really, we are not talking about months and months of certification. It will not be realistic for IoT device. So the duration is in day and optimized cost. We are talking also, I would say, about a few 10K and not 100K euro. Right? So it's you have understood you have different security assurance levels. So for the cost, yes, the last as I said, the last point to explain that really this kind of certification is being introduced very soon. So on June, so right now, so pilot are starting and Transit Object security solution are involved in this pilot. So the pilot is really to demonstrate, I would say, all the flow of the certification on a real product and to validate before, I would say, pushing the solution as the European Commission, of course. Yes. So to put in perspective what we said about the security, European security certification and LoRaWAN security. So LoRaWAN security, I would say the security was well defined in the specification and the protocol is secure. Anyway, for some use case in LoRaWAN, people does need to improve the security at the implementation level, because the protocol and the implementation is a little bit different. And I put here, some statement coming from the LoRa Alliance. The LoRa Alliance, for instance, was recommending the usage of a secure element if you think that the key are quite sensitive in your application. So it's one example. So it means that for different use cases, the security for LoRaWAN has to be improved, because you can face some threats, vulnerability, and risk if really physically the device is exposed. So if we put in perspective this security improvement, for instance, for LoRa and the certification. So even if the certification scheme are not already deployed, an IoT developer to be prepared has to think about, according to my target in terms of security, my target in terms of security assurance level, basic, substantial, I have to be prepared. And to be prepared, you have different solution on your device, for instance, to be prepared. And even if the certification scheme is not already applied on LoRaWAN device, people know that if you use the standard LoRaWAN stack, for instance, yes, you can have basic assurance level. If you really target critical application, you have to follow LoRa Alliance recommendation with the usage of secure element or IP secure element. You know that now you have IP hardware that you can embed in a system chip. So that's most of the use cases today are based on SecureElement. And what I would like to highlight also is that for the substantial, which is probably most of the application on the market today, for substantial, maybe you can select some, intermediate solution between the basic stack and the SecureElement, which is what we call today on the market a secure LoRaWAN stack, which is actually a secure library managing the LoRaWAN security and compatible with generic MCU. So we are not talking here about the addition of a SecureElement. It's a secure library compatible with generic MCU or Trezor chip and so on. So you have different options, and yes, if you are a developer, I think that you need to be prepared and to think, to manage quite fast security assessment and to be prepared according to your target in terms of security. So in conclusion, I don't know if you were aware of that, but I would like again to highlight the fact that cybersecurity regulation involving the IoT device is really coming, something important. Security assessment will help you to define what will be the good security assurance level you want to have for your application or your device. And a good way to be prepared definitely is to think about security right now during your design, but I think that you are more or less aware of this kind of preoccupation. Thank you very much.